What does one do when he realizes that the game in which he is playing is rigged? Does he continue to participate and remain silent because he worries that his long-term goals may be rendered inoperative by stepping forward to expose the illusory nature of the entire game? Does he lend the system and the game in which he finds himself credibility by continuing to engage it in such a way as to pretend that it still has legitimacy? This is the conundrum, the puzzle that faces me today. Let's say that I went to the horse track and placed a bet in which I put up my house, my future, everything necessary for my present and future success because I thought that I was placing a bet on a sure thing based upon my knowledge of one horse's potential. Now let's say that I learned that some of the other racers were causing undetectable injury to the promising horse on which I was betting in order to artificially affect the outcome in favor of those behind the fraudulent manipulation of the game. None of the audience, those placing bets, or those racers not engaged in the rigging of the results has any knowledge about this practice. Pretend that the only possible way for me to recover my initial loss is to continue to play the game by using my new understanding of how the game is played and my new insight into the manipulation of the system. If I walk away, I lose everything and flush away my future. If I stay and further participate, I become complicit in helping by lending my credibility to a system that lacks legitimacy. Would it be wise to continue to race the horse with the bird under its saddle? Would it be fair to the horse? Now, let's change the facts. Let's say that I was betting on myself. The game is law school, and the injury inflicted is caused by serious vilification through defamation campaigns, gaslighting, anchoring, neuro-linguistic programming, gang stalking, directed conversation, shunning, noise campaigns, interference with sleep, chemical contamination of the home, assaults by directed energy weapons, and various other dirty tricks. What then? I think the answer remains the same in either case. I believe I have a duty to expose this system and not lend it my credibility. I have a duty to suffer the loss, so I can free myself up to demonstrate to others who lack knowledge how the race is being manipulated and how the game is actually played. This saddens me greatly because I had such idealistic views of the justice system, but to find this occurring at the law school level does not bode well for the entire judicial system or any area of government where lawyers are involved. Those involved may view this as a victory for them. Perhaps they are right. Perhaps this is a short-term victory won through an unfair fight and only because they had the element of surprise. They caught me when I was unaware that I had enemies who sought to destroy me, nor was I aware that I was involved in total war. However, the actions I take will free up my time and resources so I can't dedicate them to fighting those enemies with every ounce of strength left in me and until my dying breath. I will not stop until this situation is rectified. Sun Tzu said that those skilled in war bring the enemy to the field of battle and are not brought there by him. All this really means is I will be choosing the battlefield and not allowing my opponents the opportunity to own the battlefield environment and control all of the methods of warfare used against me. The art of war teaches us to rely not on the likelihood of the enemy's not coming, but on our own readiness to receive him, not on the chance of his not attacking, but rather on the fact that we have made our position unassailable. By relinquishing this dream, by making my position more unassailable because my enemies can no longer use it as a weapon against me.